Hello and welcome back to Scale Me Down. Please like and subscribe to support the channel. And in this episode, we're going to conduct the maiden flight on our DB Sporting Scale quarter scale de Havilland Gipsy Moth.
Once trimmed, she soon settled down and flew in a very sedate, scale-like manner. You might have already noticed that we built this model to represent a very famous gypsy moth, Jason, flown by Amy Johnson, who was the first woman to fly solo from England to Australia in 1930. Her pioneering journey took 19 days, starting in Croydon, England, and landing in Austria, Turkey, Syria, Iraq, Iran, Pakistan, India, Burma, Thailand, Singapore, Java, West Timor before finally landing in Darwin, Australia. Her achievement was remarkable when you consider she flew the 9,500 miles without a radio and only basic maps, and certain portions of the route were completely uncharted. Amy named her second-hand gypsy moth Jason after her family business trademark. Before she learnt to fly, Amy was a qualified aircraft engineer, and she made a few modifications to her gypsy moth before the trip. We also modified this laser-cut kit to better represent her aeroplane. We modified the design for electric power by making the upper cowling removable. This left plenty of space to fit a 3D printed dummy gypsy engine. Amy removed her exhaust pipe in order to lash a spare propeller along the fuselage side in its place. Without a muffler, it must have been very noisy. The front cockpit contained an additional fuel tank and was covered over. We used this space on the model for the radio gear. We made a 3D print of Gwen to sit in Amy's seat. At the start of the trip, Jason had slats on the upper wings, and sadly they were lost or removed somewhere during the journey. And on the aeroplane currently on display in the London Science Museum, they're no longer there. We designed and added servo-driven slats to our model though. We 3D printed housings for LED navigation lights to represent another of Amy's modifications. We made rib tapes from Solartex on the laser with dots of PVA glue to represent the stitching, whilst the fuel tank was modelled with corrugated card. We also modified the rigid landing gear to include rubber shocks. Model biplanes can be a pain due to the assembly and disassembly required for storage and transportation. So we modified the design with four separate wing panels that fit quickly and simply at the field, requiring no tools. The necessary flying and landing wires are tightened with these spring-loaded tensioners. Whilst the interplane struts are connected with P-clips. For wing removal, you just squeeze these levers and pull. Back to the flight. Thank you. tried to complete a stall test, but I couldn't provoke one. I held full up elevator and she just wandered wherever she wanted to, mushing around. Gwen and I put this model together over a couple of months during the infamous lockdown of 2020. It was a pleasure to build together, and it's a joy to fly. Thanks for watching.